This video is sponsored by Enlisted. Hey everyone, it's Blackfire. Today I'm going to be digging a bit deeper into the game Enlisted, specifically the historical accuracy featured in the new multiplayer campaign called the Battle of Berlin. I did a video not too long ago on the World War II shooter. I'll put a link to that up here on the screen. But with this new update, I thought it'd be a great time to highlight some awesome attention to detail. I'll get to a few of my favorite historical details here in a minute, but if you're not familiar with Enlisted, it's a free-to-play FPS now in open beta on PC, Xbox Series X and S, as well as PS5. It features intense infantry and vehicle combat, and well, you and I both know you're not doing anything for about, say, the next couple of weeks, so use the link in the description to play for free. I've been having a blast with this game. You'll also get a free bonus for registering using that link below. And quick note here, the content I'm showcasing today is from the Battle of Berlin multiplayer campaign, currently in early access, but available to everyone. Now, if you're new to Enlisted, what sets this game apart from all the other competitors out there is a unique AI squad system. You, as a player, take control of a squad member, and you can order the rest of your squad to defend or attack objectives, and if you don't, they'll also just follow you around. If you're killed, you simply bounce to the next squad member, and once your entire squad is killed, well, then it's back to the spawn screen to select a different crew. You can also switch between your squad mates on the fly, giving you quick access to whatever you need when you need it. Although Enlisted has a lot in common with other contemporary World War II games, this squad AI mechanic is really what creates unique gameplay, in that you never know which enemy is human or computer controlled. It also means less downtime and more rewarding kill streaks, which is one of my big issues with games like Hell Let Loose or Postscriptum, for example. Enlisted keeps the historical accuracy and realism that many players crave, but it does it without all of the sweat. When you're not in combat, you can unlock new squads of soldiers, weapons, equipment, and vehicles, and you can also improve and level up your soldiers and vehicles with new perks, skills, and upgrades. Anyway, if you're already familiar with Enlisted, I just want to say I've been blown away by this new Battle of Berlin content. It's one of my favorite historical time periods, the final days and weeks leading up to the end of the war in Europe. So my first favorite historical detail here is the uniforms. Like in the other Enlisted campaigns, the game's developer Darkflow Software did an incredible job researching and modeling these. And well, you might not know that the studio is actually located in Latvia, which has some very close ties to the end of the war in Europe. Soviet forces rolled up a huge chunk of the German army there in the Courland pocket, and that's probably a big reason the developers seem to care so much about historical accuracy and the conflict. For the Battle of Berlin expansion, you'll see a lot of accurate uniforms, but I love that Darkflow included the SN-42 body armor for some Soviet squads. Now, it doesn't change anything gameplay-wise, but it instead visually highlights the bitterness of the fighting in and around Berlin, much like you see with some of the facial scars on the characters there. The SN-42 was generally issued to assault engineers and could actually stop smaller munitions like 9mm rounds at a distance of about 100 meters, as well as offering some protection from shrapnel. It's not what we would call bulletproof by modern standards, but hey, for 1945, you would be hard-pressed to find anything better. You'll also notice some Soviet troops donning early examples of camouflage, like this historically accurate amoeba pattern. For the Germans, I'm thrilled that Enlisted included the Volkssturm. Most of these soldiers were civilians, either too old or too young for regular army service, and they wound up conscripted, given minimal training, and then just pressed into service. Some of them went into combat without ever having fired a rifle. Their equipment was generally poor, and their uniforms, well, they were often anything but uniform. So Darkflow found a good balance here with gameplay and realism, including the armband, which constituted the official Volkssturm uniform and distinguish them from civilians. And this brings me to my next historical detail, the weapons. Volkssturm units in enlisted have the absolute bottom of the barrel gear, though I will say it has all been balanced for gameplay purposes. You'll see plenty of unique weapons here, like the simplified Kar 98 Kriegsmodell and the MP3008 submachine gun. That latter one is, of course, based on the British Sten. Similarly, you can also unlock a German squad equipped entirely with captured French Lebel rifles. I don't think a lot of people really understand the amount of gear that Germany reused in World War II, but it's clear that the developers of Enlisted do. You'll also find some late war ingenuity, like the MP40-1, which was a prototype equipped with two magazines on a slider to speed up reloads. For the Soviets, you'll see the PPD-40 with a drum magazine and a bayonet. All of the weapons and vehicles in Enlisted are faction-specific, with the exception of the Panzerfaust, which was used by both sides extensively in the Battle for Berlin. You'll also see some awesome late-war vehicles in the T-34-85, Panther Tank, IL-237, and the ME-410. For my third detail, let's take a look at the Reich Chancellery. Darkflow put in some serious work here, modeling the compound in some painstaking detail, especially when it comes to the main buildings. If we take a look at the marble gallery, it looks incredible and it showcases the complete destruction of the Third Reich. It really feels like this was once something fantastic and visually impressive, and now it's just been ground down to nothing by years of war. One of my favorite touches in this regard is the empty fountain near Hitler's office. The atmosphere is just so heavy and oppressive. Everything looks straight out of the real photos, and you can almost feel that desperation. Number four is easy to miss unless you know what you're looking for, and, well, quite honestly, it was built that way. Not far from the Reich Chancellery, you'll find the entrance to the infamous Führerbunker. This is where Hitler and the rest of the German political and military elite spent their final days. The entrance is a small, unassuming concrete building, and I have to say it was a real surreal experience defending this as the German team in Enlisted. It's the last objective in the invasion game mode, so your back is truly up against the wall. If you lose this point, well, the war is over. I found myself using my engineer squad to build fortifications matching all of the hurried defenses historically built in the courtyard. Playing as the Soviets, it was so powerful to feel so close to the end of the war in Europe. It was a really motivating factor, surprisingly enough. Lastly, I love what Enlisted did with the Brandenburg Gate. This is one of the most iconic locations in Germany, and it was severely damaged in World War II. What amazed me, though, and you got to look at this up close, was the level of detail that Darkflow took in modeling the structure. If you compare a photograph of the historical battle damage to what appears in the game, developers mirrored that damage almost exactly, which means two things. They did their research, and portraying things accurately really matters to them. So to that, I say, well done. There are, of course, tons of other details in Enlisted. For example, the gauges in airplanes actually work, and you can target personnel inside of tanks. But what I covered today are just a few from that early access new Battle of Berlin content. Remember, Enlisted also features the invasion of Normandy and the Battle of Moscow, which you can play right now for free. Plus, the Battle of Tunisia is also on the way. Don't forget, Enlisted still in beta, devs are making improvements constantly. Truthfully, I've enjoyed my time with Enlisted. It's been a great mix of frenetic combat, destruction, vehicle gameplay, and realism. It's been really addictive. If that sounds appealing to you, Enlisted is available for PC, Xbox One Series X and S, and PS5. It's also got crossplay, so you can play with your friends from any system. So, download Enlisted today for free and get a bonus using the link in the description below. In the meantime, tell me what your favorite detail was, or if you've been playing Enlisted and you've noticed something cool in-game, I would love to hear about it. It'd be really neat to put together a much more comprehensive video on all of the cool details in Enlisted, so if you've got any info, make sure you tell me down below in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, if not a dislike. Once again, special thank you to Enlisted for sponsoring this video. If you want to help out the channel, keep your money, share this video. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, tap the bell to get updates on all of the latest content, and of course, thanks for watching.